हेलो स्टूडेंट, माय नेम इज डॉक्टर श्वेता गोयल एंड यू आर वाचिंग द इंजीनियरिंग मास्टर द फाइनेस्ट वे टू लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फिजिक्स एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल। सो इन दिस टॉपिक इन दिस सीरीज वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड दिस इज माय फर्स्ट टॉपिक फॉर योर थर्ड यूनिट दैट इज एसी फंडामेंटल। इन दिस स्टडी वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द एसी फंडामेंटल एंड देन वी स्टडी अबाउट द एनालिटिकल मेथड, आरएमएस वैल्यू, इफेक्टिव वैल्यू, एवरेज वैल्यू, फॉर्म फैक्टर, पीक फैक्टर, दीज ऑल टॉपिक विल बी कवर्ड इन दिस लेक्चर। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ एसी फंडामेंटल। सो इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी स्टडी अबाउट द डीसी वन। सो वट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एसी एंड डीसी? सो डीसी डायरेक्ट करंट is a current which remains constant in magnitude with respect to time. Okay, so DC remains constant, the graph will be like this, any time will be there, the DC will be constant, V by R, that is constant, because current according to Ohm's law, I equals to V upon R, so current is I equals to V upon R, so V upon R we have written is, so I is constant, current is constant, okay. So this is your DC. Okay. Now, what about AC? AC supply. It is a current which changes periodically with respect to time in magnitude and direction. Okay. So what is AC? AC always changes periodically with respect to time and constant. Generally, we study about like sine wave. Okay. This is AC. On and this is your sine wave. Okay, generally we study about the AC supply. When we study about the sine wave, the amplitude of the sine wave like this. Okay, we will study all these terms, the amplitude, this, how much vertically it gone, this is positive and this is negative amplitude. This can also be a AC supply like this. Okay, any supply which is changes periodically with respect to time is called AC signal. Okay, and magnitude and direction also. So it is a complex wave, we can say. Complex wave. It can also be a AC. It is a triangular wave. Triangular wave. Okay, and it is also a AC type of AC. This is square wave. So these all are square. These all are AC waves which are changes with time with respect to time in magnitude and direction. Okay, now what are the advantage of AC over DC? We can use DC and AC both, but what are the advantage of AC over DC? Why we study AC? Because we have DC and the fluctuations are not there, the constant supply we have got. So why we use AC? AC system voltage can be raised or lower with respect with the help of transformer. Okay, so if we want to increase or decrease the transformer magnitude and direction of the system, so it can be done by the help of transformer. It is not possible in DC. High voltage transmission is possible in AC system. DC is not able to. Now we can use HVDC line, a high voltage DC line can be used, but the transmission are possible in AC only. Okay, in DC the losses are more in as per the AC system. So we use AC for the transmission. The AC system are simple in construction, cheaper and less maintenance required. In DC the maintenance are very high. In AC the system is very ill, the less maintenance is required. AC can easily convert it into DC, but DC converter is very complex system, but the AC can be converted easily in the DC. Okay, so these are some advantage of AC over DC. Okay, we can say over DC. Now, how can we generate AC? How can we generate the AC signal? So, according to Faraday's law, whenever it is relative motion between the conductor and magnetic field in which it is kept, an EMF get induced in the conductor. The relative motion may exist because of movement of conductor with respect to magnetic field and movement of magnetic field with respect to conductor. What is that means? So it means whenever it is relative motion between the conductor and a magnetic field. We can say a conductor is kept in a magnetic field, which is kept kept in a magnetic field. Then then conductor is movable in the magnetic field, because magnetic field is whenever there is a magnetic field, that is movable. Okay, movable from north to south. So a conductor, movable conductor wire kept in that field, then EMF get induced. Because of this, because of Faraday's law, I will explain how it can. I will explain how much EMF can be induced. So EMF gets induced in the conductor. The relative motion may exist because of the movement of conductor with respect to magnetic field, or movement of the magnetic field with respect to conductor. Both are related to each other. The EMF, relative motion can be exist because the movement of conductor, because of the magnetic field, and the magnetic field, movement of magnetic field because of the conductor. Both are related to each other. So, any condition is there, movement of magnetic field with respect to conductor, or conductor is movement with respect to magnetic field, the EMF will be induced. That is called Faraday's law. Okay, that is called electromagnetic induction. So let's suppose a north magnetic field is there. In the magnetic field, two poles are there, north and south poles, and the conductor wire is there. Okay, in the conductor wire, let's suppose it is made of two conductor. Okay, let's suppose this is made of two conductor. So I will do this with a different color. Let's suppose this one. Okay, so A, B, C and D. Okay, this is kept in a magnetic field. So AB is made up with a different color, different conductor, and CD is made up with a different conductor. So this is kept in a magnetic field. Magnetic field is flows like this. Okay, because north to south, always magnetic field flow like this. So magnetic field will be flow like this. Okay, and the conductor wire is there, which is movable. Okay, the magnetic flux, so it is need to cut by the conductor. If it is movable, the magnetic field will be cut by the conductor. Now please check this. You have this kind of conductor. Okay, this kind of conductor you have, and this is a magnetic field. If you are moving like this, if it is parallel, okay, if it is parallel, magnetic field not cut by the conductor, magnetic field will be flow like this. Okay, if you are movable like this, okay, any direction is there, the cut is there, and then it is perpendicular to the magnetic field. At the maximum, perpendicular 90 degree is there, so maximum flux will be cut. Okay, so and then it is movable like this, and then it is movable like different direction. So it is movable like this, conductor wire is like this and there. So please understand, please try to understand this. Moving of the conductor has a steady magnetic field, so its magnetic field cut by the conductor. Okay, there are three terms. First is magnetic flux. Okay, there are three terms. First is magnetic flux density, we can say magnetic flux and magnetic flux density. And second is active magnetic flux density, which is the, what is that? Density is basically current upon area. So how much area is going with the, how much current is going with a particular area, that will be called magnetic flux density. Okay, second will be active length. Okay, active length of conductor. What is that? Active length of conductor is that conductor which comes under the fluence. Okay, conductor which come under the influence. Okay, I can write it here. Conductor which comes under the influence. Okay. अंडर इन्फ्लुएंस मतलब जो भी कंडक्टर आपके मैग्नेटिक फील्ड के मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में आएगा. ओके, देयर इज अ सो मच कंडक्टर, लाइक कंडक्टर कैन बी लाइक दिस और मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइक दिस. ओके, सो दिस लेंथ इज कमिंग इन द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, नॉट दिस काइंड ऑफ, नॉट दिस लेंथ. सो Active length is that which comes under the influence of the magnetic field. Now third is velocity of the conductor. Okay, velocity of the conductor. So how much velocity of the conductor is there? So it depends on like this. Okay, so let's suppose we have let's suppose we have like this, north to south pole is like this and magnetic field will be like this. Okay, now now north south will be like this, so conductor wire will be made different angle at 90 degree. This is called 0 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree, 135 degree, 180 degree, 225 degree, 270 degree, then 315 degree, and then 360 degree. Please imagine that there is a conductor wire which is movable like this. Okay, and magnetic field will be parallel to parallel or perpendicular to the magnetic field. So at this point, when according to Faraday's law of EMF, okay, that is according to Faraday's law of EMF, E equals to BLV sine theta. Okay, volts, we can say volt. So EMF get induced is BLV sine theta. Okay, where B equals to flux density on magnetic field. Okay, B is equal to flux density on magnetic field. L equals to active length. I have explained all these things to you. Active length of conductor, okay, in meter, and that is Weber per meter square. Weber per meter square. Now V is velocity, meter per second. Okay, now if we can say if sine theta making this type of angle, sine 0 equals to 0, so we can make like this. Sine 0 is 0, so the signal will be at this point. Now sine is 45 degree. Okay, if sine is 45 degree, sine 40 is 1 by 2, so we can write BLV upon 2. Okay, so maximum mein it is going half of the maximum, so it will be goes like this. Now sine 90, that is 1, so E equals to BLV. Okay, E maximum will be BLV, so we can write it also like EM sine theta. So B maximum at this point. Now it is going sine 135 degree, so it going towards like this. Now sine 180 degree again 0, so it will goes like this. Now again sine 225 degree goes to minus, so it will goes like this. After that sine 270 degree it goes minus 1, so it will goes like this. Now sine 315 degree goes minus, and then 360 degree goes like this. So it will goes like this. Sine 45 degree, that is 90 degree, that is 135 degree, 180 degree, then 225 degree, 270 degree, 315 degree, and 360 degree. So it will make like this. So we can make our sine wave with this equation, EM sine theta. So this is your Faraday's law. So how we can generate our EMF equation? How can we generate our sine from the EMF equation? So it is your Faraday's law of EMF. We can generate with the different angle. Okay. So now next topic is some standard terminology is used for AC system. Instantaneous value. Value of AC at particular instant is known as instantaneous value. Okay, we can say like this. If you have like this AC signal, generally we take sine signal. Okay, so at instant let's that is at 35, 90, 180 degree. If you know, if you want to know about the instantaneous value, you have to take the value at any instant, like at 90 degree. What are the value? This is your instant value. Okay, so value at AC at particular instant is known as instant value. Amplitude, maximum value of alternating quantity attained by the positive and negative half is called amplitude. So amplitude will be this vertical section. Okay, and AC signal, this maximum vertical section, how much it goes vertically, maximum. So it is called amplitude. Now third one is cycle. Repetition of a set of positive and negative instantaneous value of the alternating quantity is called cycle. So how much repetition of positive and negative instantaneous value of the alternating quantity? So how much repetition? This is one cycle, one repetition. This is two cycle, this is three cycle, four cycle. So how much repetition from positive to negative, negative to positive? So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is your four cycle. So repetition of a set of positive and negative instantaneous value of the alternating quantity is called cycle. Now next is time period. First is cycle and second is time period. Time period is basically time taken by the alternating quantity to complete one cycle. Cycle is how much repetition is there, but time period is how much time is taken to complete one cycle is known as time period. So how much time, let's suppose it is called 1 second, so it is time period is 1 second, and then like this, that is 2 second. So number of cycles 2 and time period is 2 second. Now frequency is basically a reciprocal of time period. We can say the number of cycle represented by an alternating quantity in 1 second is known as frequency. That time period is time taken to complete one cycle. It can be 1 second, 2 second, 3 second. How much time? It doesn't matter for the time period, that how much time is taken. But it generally should complete one cycle. How much time is taken? It is not necessary. In frequency, the number of cycle completed in 1 second, it may be 4, it may be 5, it may be 1, it doesn't mean. It means only that how much cycle is completed in 1 second is called frequency. We can also denote it by F. So F is equals to 1 upon T. This is the relation between time period and frequency. In many numericals, there was given the time period and you have to calculate the frequency. And in many numericals, you have to given the frequency and you have to calculate the time period. So you can calculate from this equation. Now, next is angular frequency. Angular frequency is basically, it is a frequency in electrical radian per second. Frequency in electrical radian is called angular frequency, is denoted by omega. So omega is equals to 2 pi f radian per second, and we can also take f equals to 1 upon t, and we can write it 2 pi upon t. So these are the some equation which are interrelated to each other, and all are will be used in their numerical. So please remain these equations in your mind. So from this we can also use EMF equation by the Faraday's law, that E equals to EM sin omega t. F can be written as 2 pi f or 2 pi upon t. So we can write the EMF equation, EM equals to sin 2 pi f t and f equals to 1 upon t. So it's EM sin omega 2 pi upon t and t. So this is a difference between t and t. Okay, so please remain differentiate between them. Okay. Now, next is RMS value, or we can also say effective value. Okay, so the effective or RMS value of AC is given by steady state current DC, which when flowing through a circuit for given time produce the same amount of heat as produced by the AC, which means flowing through a same circuit for same time. What is that means? It is an RMS value, basically same as a DC value, which flowing through a circuit given time produce the same amount of heat and produced by the AC system. Let we are getting DC फ्रॉम अवर ए सी अवर हाउसेज. इसको मैं आपको हिंदी में समझाती हूँ. लाइक हमारा ए सी सिस्टम, हमारा जो घर हाउस वायरिंग होती है वो ए सी होती है. आपको कितना मिलता है? 220 वोल्ट मिलता है. ओके, इफ देर इज अ एंड यू कैन बर्न और यू कैन टेक फॉर टू बल्ब. ओके, यू कैन यूज टू बल्ब फ्रॉम दैट. Just suppose you can take two, you can glow two bulb from this 220 volt. Okay. Now there is a rectifier which is converted AC into DC or system. So you are getting DC of 220 volt, and you are also glowing two bulb from this. So there is a this is AC and this is DC. So 220 volt is the RMS value of AC, which is also which is equal to the amount of DC which producing same amount of heat and same amount of heat which is produced by the AC system. So that is called RMS value. Okay, RMS value generally is called root mean square value. RMS value is root mean square value. We will analyze in a chapter later on. So AC system is like this. So you can take DC system is this. So DC 240 volt and AC is going through this. So 240 volt AC. It is the same as the RMS value. So it means the sinusoidal RMS voltage from the wall socket of a home is capable of producing the same average positive power as 240 volt of DC. That I am telling you that to ki hamara jo ghar se jo power aayega wo bhi aapko 240 volt DC hi mile. Ab iska analysis karne ke liye you have two methods, analytical method and graphical method. We will study about both. So first of all, graphical method. Let's suppose graphical method में you have this AC system and we are taking only positive half. The positive system is there, we are taking only positive half. So VRMS value is root mean square value. So root mean square, we have to take the mean V1 square, V2 square, V3 square, V4 square up to V12 square upon number of derivation is 12. 12 instant you have take. So this is your root mean square value. For voltage, it will be under root V1 square plus V2 square plus V3 square, generally up to N. If you have N number of instantaneous, so you can take like this. For current, the same is there. For current, you can take I1 square, I2 square up to IN upon N. So this is your root mean square value. There is an analytical method also for root mean square value, that is analytical method also. Okay, let's suppose you have current, that is Im sin theta. For Faraday's law of voltage induction, you can also take Im sin theta. Okay, so you have to take a square value because root mean square value. So square value, that is I square, that is Im square sin square theta. Okay, so area of half, okay, cycle, because this is your AC current, so you have to take the area of half. So this is going 0 to pi, because when I have told you the 0, 45, 90, 180 degrees, so positive half is 0 to pi. So you will take the जीरो टू पाई लिमिट आई स्क्वायर ओके विद रिस्पेक्ट टू डी थीटा बिकॉज देयर इज अ थीटा सो लेंथ ऑफ बेस इज पाई लेंथ ऑफ बेस इज पाई सो यू टेक पाई नाउ एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ स्क्वायर वन साइकिल दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक स्टूडेंट सो प्लीज कीप इन माइंड एंड टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट और यू कैन कॉपी दिस फ्रॉम हियर वट एवर यू वॉन्ट ओके द एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ स्क्वायर ऑन हाफ साइकिल दैट विल बी एरिया ऑफ कर्व ओवर हाफ साइकिल वट इज द एरिया ऑफ कर्व ओवर हाफ साइकिल अपॉन लेंथ ऑफ बेस ओके लेंथ ऑफ बेस ओवर हाफ साइकिल नाउ एरिया ऑफ कर्व ओवर हाफ साइकिल दैट इज आई स्क्वायर डी थीटा अपॉन लेंथ ऑफ बेस दैट इज पाई लिमिट विल बी जीरो टू पाई बिकॉज वी आर टेकिंग पॉजिटिव हाफ साइकिल ओके नाउ यस वन अपॉन पाई विल बी कॉमन ओके जीरो टू पाई आई स्क्वायर डी थीटा सो यू हैव टू कैप आई स्क्वायर डी थीटा दिस आई एम साइन स्क्वायर थीटा सो वी विल कीप वन अपॉन पाई जीरो टू पाई आई एम स्क्वायर साइन थीटा डी थीटा ओके Now, sin is I m square is constant. I m square upon pi, 0 to pi, sin square theta d theta. Now, sin square theta can be written as, one minus cos theta by 2. Okay, because sin square theta can be written like this. So, we can write it like this. I m square upon pi. I hope you all know how to do integration. Okay. 0 to pi 1 minus cos theta upon 2 d theta now I m square upon pi integration will be done for both the equation so it will be like 0 to pi 1 by 2 d theta yes 1 by 2 d theta minus 0 to pi cos theta by 2 d theta now you have to do the integration of both side so I m square by pi if you do the this value this is a constant value so you will get theta theta minus theta 0 to pi okay because the limit is there 0 to pi minus cos theta sin 2 theta by 2 0 to pi if you put the limit you will get I m square by pi okay if you put the limit you will get pi minus 0 pi minus 0 minus pi minus 0 sorry we can take this 2 will be common so we can write it like this 2 pi so this like this okay sin 2 theta by 2 so sin 2 pi by 2 minus 0 sin 2 pi is 0 so it will goes like this sin 2 pi 2 pi is there so it will remain sin 0 sin 2 pi is 0 so 0 minus 0 is 0 so it will remain I m square by 2 pi into pi so pi pi cancel I m square by 2 so RMS value IRMS because this is a root square so that is I m square by 2 so this will be I m upon root 2 IRMS value okay so this is your IRMS value I m upon root 2 okay so this is your IRMS value now next is your average value okay average value basically are So average value of an AC quantity is defined as the value which obtained by averaging all the instantaneous value over a period of half cycle. So this is a half cycle and instantaneous values V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. So V average value will be the values obtained by averaging all the quantity. So V1, V2 plus V3 up to V8, then average is 8. So this is your average value. And if we talking about journal average current, that will be I1 plus I2 plus I3 up to IN upon N. And average voltage will be generally, that will be V1 plus V2 plus V3 up to Vn upon N. So this is your average value. There is also a graphical and analytic method to calculate the average value. So first of all, the graphical method will be there. So graphical method is same as the analytical method, that is like this. Okay, so this is your graphical method. Now we will say about the analytical method. Okay, so analytical method is, or we can say like this, let's suppose this is your instantaneous values, that is your theta angle. Okay, theta angle, this is your frequency omega, and one cycle is this. Okay, area under the curve, this is your area under curve. Okay, now this is your peak voltage. Average value is obtained by taking the ratio of, okay, we can write average value is taking ratio of area under curve over half cycle to length of base, which is pi, length of base. Okay, so we can write I average is equal to area under curve of half cycle then length of base. Okay, length of base. So this is your I average. Or we can also take the voltage average here. Okay, the method is same. So area under the curve, that is 0 to pi is limit, then pi d theta upon I d theta upon pi, base of pi. So here 0 to pi I is Im sine theta d theta upon pi. So pi is constant. We can take it outside of the integration, 0 to pi, and Im is also constant. So Im can be taken the constant. So sine theta d theta here. Now Im upon pi, 0 to pi sin theta d theta. So sin theta is minus cos theta integration is there. So 0 to pi is limit. So here you can write Im upon pi cos minus cos pi. So minus cos theta. So that is cos pi plus cos 0. So cos 0 is 1 and cos pi is 1. So here you cos pi is minus 1. So Im upon pi, that is minus minus 1 plus 1, that is 2. So we can write it 2m upon pi. So this is your I average value. If you keep the value of I average pi value, so 2 upon pi, that is 0.637. So you can write 0.637 Im, that is your आई एवरेज वैल्यू, इफ यू हैव द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू यू कैन कैलकुलेट द एवरेज वैल्यू. ओके, एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट वी एवरेज दैट इज 0.637 आई एम. इफ यू इन टू विद द 0.637 यू कैन ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट डायरेक्टली द एवरेज वैल्यू. ओके, नाउ टू टर्म्स आर ऑल्सो देयर, दैट इज फॉर्म फैक्टर एंड पीक फैक्टर. ओके, दीज आर ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म. फॉर्म फैक्टर, फॉर्म फैक्टर इज डिनोटेड बाय केएफ एंड इट इज अ आरएमएस वैल्यू अपॉन एवरेज वैल्यू. ओके, सो आरएमएस वैल्यू जनरली यू कैन से आरएमएस वैल्यू दैट इज आईएम अपॉन रूट टू. ओके, अपॉन एवरेज वैल्यू दैट इज आईएम टू आईएम अपॉन पाई. सो आईएम आईएम कैंसिल दैट टू pi under root 2 pi upon 2. If you all are the constant value, if you solve this you will get 1.11. okay, so this is your form factor 1.11. if there is a form factor you can directly calculate, you can directly put the 1.11 because these all are constant. Now another is peak factor. Okay, so peak factor basically a maximum value upon RMS value. So peak factor that is maximum value upon RMS value. So maximum value that is IM upon RMS value that is IM upon root 2. Okay, so IM IM cancel, only root 2 is there. So you can 1 upon root 2 is there. Okay, so root 2 is 1 upon 1 root 2, no, only root 2 is there. So that is 1.414. you can also take this KP. So KP peak factor is 1.414. these are some constant value which will be very useful for your numerical problem, and we will do some numerical problem in our next session. Please stay tuned for new topics. So thank you, good day, and take care.